Welcome back to the MathsCraft New Zealand series of videos on constructing the Menger sponge. In this video, we're going to learn the first step in making the Menger sponge. This is the Menger sponge. It's made from cardstock underneath this paper cut cladding. So this is what it looks like without the cladding. It's made up of cardstock made into cubes and then joined together. So each face of the Menger sponge is made up of 8 cubes. In this first video, we're going to learn how to make a cube. To make a cube, you will need 6 business cards or 6 pieces of cardstock. To begin, place one card face up on the table and a second card face down on top of it. And you want to make sure the cards are at right angles. I like to line up the top of this top card, this top edge of the top card, with the T in MathsCraft. That's a pretty good folding guide. So then you just fold the top card over and get a good crease. Turn it around, make sure the top card is sitting into the crease at the bottom, and fold it again. So now you've created 2 flaps. And we call these flaps tabs. So we're going to do the same to the bottom card. So once again, you want to line up the T in MathsCraft with this white edge and then fold. Give it a good crease because this will help with the cube construction later. And that's finished. So now you just want to pull these apart and you want to do it quite gently, because the less you disturb the folds, the better. You've now got 2 folded cards. Do this twice more, so you end up with 6 folded cards, like this. To start building the cube, we're going to use 1 card for each face of the cube. And I'm going to show you the 2 rules for joining cards together. Each card has 2 sides which are tabs and 2 sides which are tab-free. When we're joining 2 cards together, a tab side of one card always goes with a tab-free side of another card, and you'll join them together so that the tabs always end up on the outside of the cube. So that's the rule for putting the cards together. I'll now show you how to make a cube. So start with the base of the cube. Then for our first side piece, we're going to take, we've got a non-tab side here, a tab-free side here. So we use a tab here and we tuck it underneath. And that's the first side of our cube. For the next side, we've got a tab here, so we use a tab-free side here, and we tuck it in to make sure that all the tabs are on the outside. For the third side, we have a tab-free side to our card here, so we use a tab side of our card, and we tuck that underneath and tuck it behind any existing tabs. There's one tab here for the fourth wall of our cube, so we use a tab-free side and we slot that in. So now all our cube is missing is a top. You'll see that these cards have fallen in a bit, and that's completely fine. So we'll take the last card, turn it over, and we've got a tab side here. Put the non-tab side of our card in, lift up the final tab and tuck it in. And that's your cube complete. So as you're putting your cube together, it will feel quite unstable, but as soon as you put the last card in place, you should feel that it's quite stable and it holds together really well. You won't need tape or glue. If your cube feels unstable, pull it apart and try again. In order to make a Menger sponge, you'll need to make 20 cubes. Once you have your 20 cubes, join us in the next video to learn how to put two cubes together.